of destruction against his own people, what must have happened? He says, "Oh Allah, now that I've told you everything and I've explained it one after the other, do not leave a single one of them on this earth." And do you know what Allah says? We read the verse, the last verse yesterday. And there is another verse I'd like to read. Allah says,
وَنُوحًا إِذْ نَادَى مِن قَبْلُ فَاسْتَجَبْنَا لَهُ.
In Surah Al-Anbiya, Allah says, and Nuh alayhi salam called out to us a long time ago. We answered him immediately. We answered him immediately because it took him so long to make this dua. The point we raised yesterday is, remember, those who are friends of Allah, those who are close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Muslimin, those who are trying to earn the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, never harm them. If they raise their hands, they won't do so immediately. They will make dua, Ya Allah, guide this person. Ya Allah, have mercy on this person. Ya Allah, bless this person. But when we engage in their lives negatively, they may come a point in their lives when they will say, Ya Allah, destroy this person. That's the end. Then we are wondering, why is my life a mess? I usually like to tell people, if your life is in total chaos, is there anyone who is serving the cause of Allah? Any scholar of Islam that you've ever harmed? That's the first question you should ask yourself. If you have, whether you have spread rumor about him or harmed him or attacked him or blocked him or did whatever, your life is doomed. Doomed. Why? Because he works for Allah. His boss will sort you out. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. It's a powerful statement. Think about it. Sometimes our lives are in a mess. We don't know what we've done against one of the friends of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and we're trying to find the button that went wrong, and we're trying to press the right button, and we don't know. Our lives are upside down. Remember, if you cannot benefit someone, minimum, don't harm them. Allahu Akbar. If you cannot benefit someone, minimum, don't harm them. And those who are friends of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if negative thought goes through your mind, remember something. You better block it very quickly. And don't allow it to continue. Who knows, they might be closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala than anyone else. And the day they say, Ya Allah, this person is now troubling me, destroy them. Believe me, if not today, in a few years time, it's coming. Before you die, you taste it. Not after death. Before you die, you taste it. And then after the death, it will continue. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala safeguard us. So Nuh alayhi salam says, رَبِّ لَا تَذَرْ عَلَى الْأَرْضِ مِنَ الْكَافِرِينَ دَيَّارًا. Ya Allah, don't even keep one of them on this earth. إِنَّكَ إِن تَذَرْهُمْ يُضِلُّوا عِبَادَكَ وَلَا يَلِدُوا إِلَّا فَاجِرًا كَفَّارًا. If you leave them on this earth, Ya Allah, you know what will happen? They will be leading people astray. That's all they know. And they are not giving birth to anyone except those who are worse than them. Which means their children, Ya Allah, they are thus the same, if not worse. So Ya Allah, there's no hope even for their children. Allahu Akbar. When he made this dua, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala responded. And in Surah Hud, Allah says, after that,
وَأُوحِيَ إِلَىٰ نُوحٍ أَنَّهُ لَنْ يُؤْمِنَ مِنْ قَوْمِكَ إِلَّا مَنْ قَدْ آمَنْ فَلَا تَبْتَئِسْ بِمَا كَانُوا يَفْعَلُونَ.
We revealed immediately to Nuh alayhi salam that, O Nuh, we've heard your dua, we've heard what you said. Now we want to tell you that we have sealed the hearts of the people at this point. Nobody from today will accept your message. It's over. Whoever is with you is with you. Now we have crossed to a new level. Allahu Akbar. So Nuh alayhi salam stopped calling people towards Allah at that point. Why? Because Allah told him, from this moment, no new people are going to accept your message. It's over. We gave them a chance. My beloved brothers and sisters, I learned a lesson from this, and so should you. What is the lesson? Allah gives you one chance to turn, two chances to turn, 10 chances to turn, 1,000 chances to turn. After that, he might throw you right out. Allahu Akbar, may he not do that to me, and may he not do that to you. We need to turn now, because I don't know if this is going to be the last chance that Allah is giving me. Who can guarantee that they are going to stand up from here alive? Anyone? We can put up our hands. Allahu Akbar. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala safeguard us. Death is a whisker away. We are fortunate. Inna Allah ta'ala yaqbilu tawbat al-abdi ma lam yugharghir. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, Allah will accept the repentance of a worshipper for as long as their soul is not being taken out of their throats. May Allah open our doors and grant us acceptance. Remember, it is not difficult to turn to Allah. It requires willpower. It requires iman and belief. And we have that, inshallah, by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah says,
وَاصْنَعِ الْفُلْكَ بِأَعْيُنِنَا وَوَحِيْنَا.
Allah says, we want you, O Nuh, to create or to make an ark. We want you to build an ark. Amazing verse. Nuh alayhi salam was not a carpenter, he was not a builder. He didn't know anything about building. And Allah says, we want you to do something. We will help you, we will guide you, we will be watching, and we will instruct you what to do. So what happened? Amazingly, the tree would grow, he would cut it down, take it to the top of the mountain, because Allah instructed him to build that ark at the top of the mountain. And when he took it and laid it there, he was granted dusur, he was granted nails, and he would nail one into the other. When he went back, there was another tree ready for him. He would cut it down and bring it. When he brought it, it would fit like a jigsaw with the other one, and he would nail it in. Amazing. And his people,
وَكُلَّمَا مَرَّ عَلَيْهِ مَلَأٌ مِّن قَوْمِهِ سَخِرُوا مِنْ.
Every time the cronies, mala meaning the chiefs, the big boys in community, when they passed him, they used to laugh at him. Ya Nuh, صِرْتَ نَجَّارًا بَعْدَ أَن كُنْتَ نَبِيًّا. You've now become a carpenter, we're seeing. You used to be a prophet, you stopped calling us, at least. But now you're becoming a carpenter, but we want to give you a piece of advice. Scoffing at him, they said, you want to build an ark or a ship, you'd rather do it on the coast. Because how are you going to take it from here today? Is a jinn going to come and carry it for you all the way there? And he kept quiet. He says,
إِن تَسْخَرُوا مِنَّا فَإِنَّا نَسْخَرُ مِنْكُمْ كَمَا تَسْخَرُونَ.
You want to laugh at us today, don't worry. A day is going to come when we will be laughing at you. Nuh alayhi salatu wasalam, the Prophet Noah, may peace be upon him. So it is reported that that ark, now what I'm about to say now, Allah knows best. We've got it in a narration that we've taken from the people of the book, as I explained yesterday, the Israeli riwayat, and the Quran neither agrees with it nor rejects it. So we're just making mention of it. They say the ship or the ark was 900 meters long. Now the people were also very, very tall. Remember, we spoke about them being 18 meters tall. So it was 900 meters long, and it was 150 meters wide and 90 meters high, because it was more like a submarine. He covered the top as well. It was not a ship with the top open. It was covered as well, more like a submarine ready to go. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala taught Nuh how to build this state of the art piece. Only by him coming back, cutting the tree, and it fits. Coming back, cutting the tree, and it fits. Imagine what must have happened. Subhanallah. Subhanallah. Allahu Akbar. Just think of a jigsaw. Very difficult one. And you're looking that way and someone gives you the right piece, you fit it in. You're looking the other way, they give you the right piece, you fit it in. How happy you are. Wow, we completed this whole map of Africa in a little while. Subhanallah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us an understanding. So here Nuh alayhi salatu wasalam was now ready. It is reported, also another Israeli narration, that it took almost 100 years to build that ark. Allah knows best. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says,
حَتَّى إِذَا جَاءَ أَمْرُنَا وَفَارَتَّ النُّورُ قُلْ نَحْمِلْ فِيهَا مِنْ كُلٍّ زَوْجَيْنِ اثْنَيْنِ وَأَهْلَكَ إلا من سبق عليه القول ومن آمن وما آمن معه إلا قليل.
We gave him a sign, Nuh alayhi salam, that when you see the sign, and the sign was that the earthen oven would gush forth with water. When you see water coming up from the ground, then you start preparing by taking tools of all the animals and tools of all the creatures of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and your family besides the one whom Allah has rejected, And we will get to that inshallah. And take with you those who have believed. And Allah is telling us, وَمَا آمَنَ مَعَهُ إِلَّا قَلِيلٌ. We want you to know that those who believed with him were very, very few. Qalil. Qalil means very few. I told you, either between 11 or from 11 to 80 people. The narration that makes mention of the smallest number speaks of 11, and the narration that makes mention of the highest number is 80. But that is little. For 950 years of da'wah, only 80 people accepted. And from this, we learn something. That the majority is not always correct. Subhanallah. The Quran speaks about it.
وَإِن تُطِعْ أَكْثَرَ مَنْ فِي الْأَرْضِ يُضِلُّكَ عَنْ سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ.
Not always is the majority correct. When you follow the majority of those on earth, they may lead you astray from the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So not always. What is right, even if the whole globe is telling you it's wrong, and you're the only one left. And what is wrong, even if the whole globe is engaging in it, and they see nothing wrong with it. Even if you're the only one left. Allahu Akbar. May Allah keep us on the straight path. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, we then told him, carry these people with you, and get into the ark. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says,
وَقَالَ ارْكَبُوا فِيهَا بِسْمِ اللَّهِ مَجْرَاهَا وَمُرْسَاهَا إِنَّ رَبِّي لَغَفُورٌ رَحِيمٌ.
He said to them, come, let's ride in this ark. We're all inside now, and we want to make a dua. And this dua, to this day, we make it, and we are taught to make it when we are on journey. One of the duas that is a sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. بِسْمِ اللَّهِ مَجْرَاهَا وَمُرْسَاهَا. In the name of Allah, it will move and it will stop. You know, we hear about those Lexus motor vehicles that have a defect with the brakes. I hope those people did not forget to read that dua. Because it goes with Allah's instruction and with His name, and it should stop with it as well. So don't think that it's going to stop just by pressing the brake. It's Allah who grants that brake. Whatever is needed for it to catch. And wallahi, there are people, I read a story that in one of the highways of Saudi Arabia, 3 days ago, it was in the Arab News newspaper, they said there was a man whose brakes failed at 200 kilometers per hour. And he phoned, luckily he had a phone, and it was on the highway between Rabigh and Jeddah. And he phoned the traffic police, and he told them, this is who I am, this is where I am, and this is what has happened. I'm on cruise control and it's not coming off and my brakes have failed. You can actually Google it, you'll find the story. And what happened? They escorted him at that speed and they opened up all the roadblocks for him until his fuel ran out. Allahu Akbar. Look at Allah's gift on this man. Imagine if it was here, I don't think we would have had that long roads for the fuel to run out. And this is a true story. It happened 3 days ago, not longer than that. So this is why it's important for us to read the dua. Jump in the vehicle. Don't just think, right, jump in, start, I've got the latest Merc and I'm going. No. Bismillahi majreha wa mursaha. In the name of Allah, it will go, and in the name of Allah, it will stop. Inna Rabbi laghafurur rahim. Indeed, your Rabb is most forgiving, most merciful. There is another dua as well that we can read. Subhanalladhi sakhara lana hadha wa ma kunna lahu muqrinin. It's a longer dua with a similar meaning. These are the prayers. So, now what happened? Allah says, وَهِيَ تَجْرِي بِهِمْ فِي مَوْجٍ كَالْجِبَالِ. The ark is moving, being guided by Allah through waves which are like mountains. And Nuh alayhi salam is looking out as they're closing this thing here, and he sees his son, and his son did not want to be with him. This is what we were saying, that you take your family besides those whom Allah has rejected or turned away. His son was a quiet boy. He didn't want to be with his father, and he was with the other side. So his father says,
وَنَادَى نُوحٌ ابْنَهُ وَكَانَ فِي مَعْزِلٍ يَا بُنَيَّ ارْكَمْ مَعَنَا وَلَا تَكُمْ مَعَ الْكَافِرِينَ.
Nuh alayhi salam calls out to his son saying, oh my son, come and ride with us. Don't be with the disbelievers. Come into the ark. And his answer was as follows.
قَالَ سَآوِي إِلَى جَبَلٍ يعصمني من الماء.